once again, we come into your presence with expectancy in our hearts. God, we know you're going to bless us. So we lift our hands in the sanctuary and we give you glory and honor and praise. Come on, come on.
We lift our hands in the sanctuary. We lift our hands to give you the glory. We lift our hands to give you the praise. And we will praise you for the rest of our days.
Yes,
yes. We will praise you for the rest of our days.
We lift our hands.
We lift our hands in the sanctuary.
We lift our hands.
We lift
Sister Darius here. I hope you are well. I hope God is your source, and I hope you are still utilizing him in every area of your life, good, bad, right, wrong, flaws and all. He is a wonderful counselor, a mighty God, the everlasting Father, and he's also the Prince of Peace. Utilize him in every area of your life, particularly the areas that you can mature in, grow in, and be better, because at the end of the day, God speaks to us as individuals to be our very best in and through him and through his word, okay? All right, let us pray. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for your word being a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway for real in real life, and how to utilize your word that no matter what happens, there's a navigation or a GPS, God's positioning system, that really takes out the global positioning system and gives us a place of peace. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, thank you all so much for tracking with us. It's the month of December. There's a lot going on. Stay in God's word for all directions and guidance, and I promise you that even if things are not what you want them to be, he'll always do more protecting then he will be rewarding. I would rather be in a safe place until things happen the way I want to than to kind of sort of push or go faster than I need to and put myself in harm's way and wish I hadn't, okay? All right, we love you. Thank you so much again for tracking with us and being with us at Grace Central. We are growing, people are joining Grace Central, and we're maturing and growing, just wanting to be our best in and through God's word, amen? All right? Our capital campaign, Grace Central, is doing our Grace Central capital campaign outreach. We're getting there. We're moving forward every week. My prayer and desire is that this number go up in leaps and bounds towards the objective that we're trying to do. And we could do this with your help. Our capital campaign is to raise $500,000 to begin the work we need to do this work, feeding the hungry, setting the captives free, every Tuesday from 5 to 7, 8 different townships. Y'all, we over here at Grace Central doing it, making a difference in people's lives, not just the spiritual perspective, but the physical perspective as well. They are like 8 and 9, 10 blocks out, and we are really excited that we're servers and have a passion to do it. So support us. Let us know, hey, we got y'all back. We seeing what you guys are doing, and it's to a good cause. It's our free drive through pickup, and we'll be doing it Christmas, December the 19th. Come. There's no reason no one should be without food, particularly the natural food, to be able to live and be strong in a spiritual place when it comes to God's word for us. I call the word of God the good news because it prunes us, it matures us, it chastens us. It lets us know when we're doing well. It lets us know when we're not doing not so good when it comes to God's word. At the end of the day, of course, y'all know the greatest gift God has ever given us is the gift of choice. So whether his word is here or not, we have a choice to choose. And God has given us this gift, and he's not going to take that gift of choice away. So we have to choose which way and which walk we want to choose, so that it will be what we really want, our heart's desire. Do we want to do it our way, which is not bad if that's what you want, or do you want to do it God's way, which is why we're here? Because Romans 8:28 says, "And for we know that all things work together for the good to them who love God, who are called according to his purpose." Amen? All right, so you really want God's word choice that's better than ours in any kind of way, shape, or form. So here's a part of the good news that I like, that God is sharing with us some great information that we need. Reading this made me really understand my position and how I'm doing things. Watch this. Darius, yes. "For the mystery of iniquity," watch this, y'all, "doth already work. Only he who now letteth will be until he be taken out of the way. I'm going to explain this crazy, amazing information. Tonight, this Tuesday, I want to use for a thought, if you could track with me. It may be held down, but it won't be held back. It may be held down, but it won't be held back. Okay? All right? All right. Check this out. And when you study God's word, it's a revelation. God only gives revelation to people who seek him. You could be the smartest person in the world and you can have it going on, but the revelation of God's word or things to be revealed, it's outside of the natural or my own way of thinking and my thoughts. So the spiritual perspective is when I study God's word and get his language on things, and then I study it to see what God is saying. Like reading the word of God right now for me, and if you're reading it for you, this is what he's sharing with me in my world, with my steps and my address, how I'm doing things. And if you're reading it, he's going to deal with you with his word to you, where you are, your address, and how you're doing things. So he says this, check this out. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work, or the mystery or the stuff that you don't see of iniquity, your iniquity is sin, it's ill ambitions, it's positions that hurt us. Sin are positions that hurt us. And we often have the choice to put ourselves in some positions or take ourselves out of positions. This right here is sharing with us that it doesn't matter what you're doing or thinking, that the mystery of iniquity or the outcome of iniquity or sin, sin are ill ambitions. We are ambitious about what we're doing, and it's unhealthy the way we're doing it. Whenever we're sinning, it's the bad stuff or the wages that comes back on us to let us know, watch this, that this is the mystery of this, or when you don't think things through, or when you're just making crazy decisions and choices, when you know there's an answer for it. I often share with Grace Central, I'm going to keep saying it, God is so amazing, he'll teach us how to do wrong right. And some of the areas that we do outside of the humanness is to happen, but we're to mature and grow. That growth is an indication of life. And sometimes we have to do things outside of the norm to grow. But even there, we are responsible to make sure that while we're growing or doing things, watch this, nobody's hurt here. Or he's saying, if you don't do it like this, how you're doing what you're doing, the mystery of iniquity doth, y'all look at this, already work. In other words, whatever you're doing that you're not paying attention to, it's already working, that it's designed to mess you up. It's right here. Or mess me up. Mm-hmm. It's right here. For the mystery of evil or sin or the things we do to put ourselves in harm's way, listen, it don't need our help. It's going to already do what it's designed to do. Here it is right here. The mystery of iniquity doth already work. It's kind of sort of like if you got one of the officers out and you running a red light, it ain't no doubt that if he's there, you're going to jail. I don't care how you didn't intend to do it, you're going to jail. In other words, sin, the word of God put it like this, the wages of sin or the wages of the things that we're not using God's word on properly, the wages of it is death. He's not talking about like dying in the casket death. He's talking about death spiritually, that we're not utilizing a awesome tool that could help us not put ourselves in harm's way. And it's not even just the things we do. And I share with you that sometimes iniquity are the things we're not doing. He says, for the mystery of this thing called sin, iniquity, is already at work. It's already working. We don't need our help. Watch this. Only look at how he's sharing this. Only he who now letteth will let, or check this out. He who keep letting this happen like that is the one that let it. In other words, this stuff can't happen unless we let it happen. Look, only he, singular, who now let it will be. Or a person who just keep letting this happen is the only one that needs to understand that the reason this is happening is because of me. Darius, you ain't paying attention to God's word. And the only reason this is happening, Darius, is because of me. And if whatever you're dealing with is not getting better, or God's word is not showing you a different way of looking at it, the only one that's doing it is you. Mm-hmm. Yep. I am excited about understanding. Can't nobody push my buttons but me. And I shouldn't let no one be able to push my buttons. I should always operate in excellence and order. But there are some situations and some moments that put me in a position to learn. Often, sometimes, the only way we can learn is by doing things to grow and mature, which is why he says, you ain't got to worry about it growing us up. It's going to do it. But he's also saying, and the only one that can let this happen is the person that do this without using God's word. Watch this. And he will let it keep happening. Look at how he's articulating this for me. Until he be taken out of the way. Look. He be taken out of the way, or I take myself out of the way of letting things happen the way I want them to versus the way God wants them to. It ain't going to change until I get my butt out the way. That's what this is saying. What's in your life right now that you need to get out the way so God can utilize his word, which is not bad. You doing you ain't bad if that's what you want. But if it's putting you in a place where it's unhealthy and there's some things that's making your life not so good. He says, this is not going to change until you get out the way and not use the mystery of what you don't see sin doing to stop you from being hurt. Yeah, you got to do it. You got to get the information on your situation that brings revelation for your elevation so you can reach your destination with a confirmation while never losing inspiration. Okay? You got it? All right. Crazy, amazing word. It's right here in the word, that 2 Thessalonians 2:7. He's teaching us that a lot of the stuff that we hurt from, we do it. Mm-hmm. Yep. And so he's trying to tell us that if we're going to really work his word, that the only way we're going to work it is to get ourselves out of the way. Say, self, it may be held down, but it won't be held back. A lot of things we think about in our conscience, and often the voice that we have without God's word in our head is often a lot of wants and desires that sounds real good. But really, when we think about it, it appears to be a lot of hard work. When we're trying to do our very best, it seems like it's so hard for it to come to pass. You have a wish list? Do you have a wish list? Mm-hmm. That God could just show you everything in such a way that in your normal physical being, you could be so clear on it. Well, get in line, because I have. Lord Jesus, which is one of the reasons I wrote your will, is what's best for me, because I wanted to get out of God's way. I want to stay out of God's way, and everything that I need to learn to mature, that the mystery of sin that's designed to hurt me, or the mystery of sin when it comes to iniquity and the things that we put ourselves in, because that's what sin is the situations and the experiences that we put ourselves in, that he says is going to do what it's supposed to do until we get ourselves out the way. I wrote your will because I didn't want to keep putting myself in harm's way and not understand God's definition of growth, because you can grow safely. They call it safe places. Oh, yes. You can grow in right environments where the right kind of people, you could be you and mature and go to another level without the repercussions of it. Because God doesn't judge our behavior. He judged the thoughts and the intent of the heart. So you got to want to not be able to hurt somebody even while you're growing, because you could do better there than not caring about what you're doing, and what you do hurt a lot of people, even yourself. So knowing God's word is amazing. I was reading about the Israelites and how God used just miracles to get them to see that he had their best interests at heart. He used a cloud of fire. Look in the Word of God where he was dealing with the Israelites, and he used a cloud of fire to suddenly over their heads begin moving the cloud of fire in the precise direction that they were going in. Or God often want to make sure we don't miss him by sending us some signs. Sometimes I really can use God for me right now like this, even as we speak. I'm in a position to look for some kind of cloud without me knowing God's word to lead me, which is why, unfortunately, some of the things we look at on Facebook will never speak to us personally. Twitter, IG. Yeah. In context of how God speaks to us personally, he don't use my way. Or other ways, Facebook, Twitter, IG, MySpace, beepers. You're right, exactly. He don't use areas like that to speak to us. That's for the masses. And when we utilize these avenues, it often holds us back because it has nothing to do with the street or where we are literally and figuratively. We're on. Or what we're dealing with, all of those avenues becomes distractions. And when we don't hear God's word for our real life, these avenues hold us down. There's some opinions of others I used. There's some opinions of even me I used. And I was not happy, or there was no liberty in my movement, and it held me down. Although I use the whole word of God, particularly in the Old Testament, when they wanted to hear God, God spoke to his people as a whole through the person of a prophet. And a prophet is simply a messenger that speaks a good message. You got people who speak messages or say things who are not prophet. But the root word of prophet is profitable. So whatever you're getting should be profitable. But using God's word, you can only utilize prophet from a spiritual perspective. And they that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. That's why all profitable things are not profitable. That's why all money ain't green, because it's not what we do, but how we do it that sets up God's precedent. For our outcome, the blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich and added no sorrow with it. These are God's perspective ways of doing things and not being held down. Because then that was the only way people could confirm things, prophets, messages, was through a visible sign. Prophecy and signs went hand in hand. Back then, they saw somebody of God's word saying something, and then they saw a sign that it literally and physically worked, literally and figuratively, physically worked. A God message was accompanied by a great work that produced a God's promise perspective. Today, you can't do this on your own. And if you try on your own using other people's methods, you'll probably wind up getting what they have, doing what they're doing, operating the way they're operating, just like them. Which means the things that you accomplish, watch this, y'all, they won't be meaningful. They will be pleasurable. And let me tell you something about the difference from pleasure and meaningful. When people don't have meaningful things in their lives, they are distracted by pleasures. And when you're distracted by pleasures and there's nothing meaningful in your life, it's a contract to be held down. Everything God does in our heads and our hearts when his word is really our desire, it's not to ever be held down. And his promises will never be held back. God has a plan for you and me. And outside of his plan is designed for his promise to be held down. But when you get into God's word and to his perspective of how he does things, you won't be held back. God's word also, just FYI, produces a certain kind of people, a certain kind of places, and a certain kind of experiences that assist us when some people, places, and things won't work. He has some people, some places, and some experience that assist us, that when we trust him and trust his word, these places or these kind of places that he sends us puts you and me around unique kinds of different people, environments, experiences, and places. That if you're in a place right now that's holding you down, using his kind of people, places, and things, you won't be held back. Find those who can assist you in being your very best you without wanting you to be held back. And if you use God's word, know them that labor among you, how can two walk together except they be agreed? Wait a minute. I know you think I'm talking about people, places, and things, and I am. But whenever you read and study in God's word, the first covenant that he talks to is you and him. When he says, how can two walk together except they be agreed? He is talking about me and someone else. But he's really talking about there is how you and I going to walk together if we don't agree that I'm the source and you'll use me for you versus that. That's how you read God's word. Everything about God from Genesis to Revelation starts with me and the word. And then it goes from there for me to decide how I make the choices and decisions for my life. Here, when we utilize God's word, there's nothing that will be held back, but we won't get it our way. We'll get it his way. You ever waited on a deal or something to go down? It's kind of sort of like this. Right before winter, everything that you know you get for summer goes on sale. So if you could wait for a lawnmower to be bought like October, you will get a better deal than waiting for winter to be over and spring finna come because they know people are going to need a lawnmower. They old and broke. You get it? So when you don't use God's word and you do things out of order, you'll be held down. But when you use God's word, as he said to us today, for the mystery of this, doing this kind of stuff, it's already at work. It's not, it doesn't have no respect of person. Yeah. I don't care who I am or you, if it's out of order and out of God's word, the word of God says, oh, you don't got to be worried about it. It's already at work. It's designed to tear your butt down. There is all your thoughts that's outside of my word, and you not being your best you, it's designed to tear you down. That's how this thing goes. And only he that hold it back will hold him back. It's like, if you read this, it says, the only one that can hold themselves back is the one that's holding themselves back, you and me. Yeah. Watch this. Until I'm taken out of the way. Or until you really understand, you could be strong all you want, but until you take you out the way, you're going to be held back. But if you decide to take you out of the way, nothing God has for you will be held back. You getting in your way will always hold you down. It will never give you God's best. But when you use his word, and here's one of the ways to use his word, there is the outcome of evil or things that you're not paying attention to, not human, just stuff that we don't think things through. He says already at work to destroy you, there is. And if you're looking at it like that, what are you not doing to be your very best? Even if it's family, close, husband, wife, are you communicating well? Are you in a situation where you could be honest with somebody and tell them the truth and they can receive it and grow from there? Or will you won't go talk to somebody and just be mad? Which road are you taking? Because if you're not using God's word, it'll hold you down. But using God's word, where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. He that the Son has set free is free indeed, which means nothing God has for us will be held back. We know that iniquity already is set up for us to fail. But if we get ourselves out the way and utilize God's word, it's nothing that God has for us that will be held back. I'm a witness. I want everything God has for me his way. And I've never been so happy in this place utilizing God's word. Even in my humanness, I want to have God there too. Wherever I want to grow, I want God there to grow with me. Watch this. If I'm the kind of person who know how to take care of me and I grow with somebody who know how to take care of them, they're not going to hurt them and they're not going to hurt me. But if I grow with the wrong kind of person and all they see is what they can get from me, that growth can be a not so normal thing, but it can also hurt a person. When you're not walking with the right kind of person, it's designed to hold you down. Mm-hmm. But when you walk in with the right kind of person, even in your maturity, neither of you would do stupid stuff to be held back, because even two bank robbers got to be bank robbers to rob a bank. One shouldn't be a believer in the bank robber. You get my point. Yeah. Darius, it may be held down, but with me, it won't be held back. Let us pray. Lord, we love you. Thank you for the word today that you showed us that it's going to produce already. It doesn't need our help. Craziness doesn't need our help. And whoever operate there, craziness will produce craziness. And you told us in your word today that the only one that can stop craziness is not crazy going away, but me stop operating in crazy. And when I get myself out the way of operating in crazy, crazy will go away, because I'll use your word for a lamp unto my feet and a light into my pathway. Thank you for this word today reminding us we ain't got to worry about crazy happening. As long as we're doing it and in the way of it, it's going to happen. But if we decide to get out of the way and let your word be our light, nothing you have for us will be held back. In Jesus' name, amen. Powerful, ain't it? Yeah, crazy, amazing. All right. Thank you so much for your word, the word of God. Thank you for listening. Join some people together on Tuesdays so you can get the word. Remind yourself that everything that happens to me is my fault. Yeah. Meaning, even if something is crazy that happened yesterday, it's up to me to erase that and start today and create tomorrow. Yeah. And we had a crazy, amazing message on Sunday when I shared with them that we're to use God's word daily. Every day I wake up, daily. I got it on my wall at home. Daily will I seek him. Yeah, daily I reproduce his word, because what happened yesterday, crazy, doesn't mean it happened and stay today. Straighten that thing out. Make today what you want tomorrow to be and keep it moving. Because when God is in your heart, you keep things moving. That's how you know it's God. All right? We love you. Let's do the actions. These actions this Tuesday, 12:05, is crazy amazing. Did you enjoy that word? Thank you so much. I want you to write to me and say, Pastor, that really helped me. I really enjoyed you sharing with me how I get in my way of doing crazy things. And once I get out of my way, God's word will never be hold back what he has for me. It's true. Here's one. One of my strengths is self-control. Mm-hmm. Here's two. I won't allow my feelings to overpower what I know is God's truth. A lot of work there. Here's three. I'm dangerous when I observe, comprehend, and think things through. I'm dangerous when I observe, comprehend, and think things through. That last action connects to today's message. I'm dangerous when I comprehend God's word and think things through, because without question, I'll know for sure. I may be held down, but I won't be held back. It's true, y'all. It's true. He can change any situation once you renew your mind and your heart. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Ways to give. You already know Grace Central Church, 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois. You can Zelle us, Grace Central Church. You can do credit or debit, online giving, gracecentral.net. You can also write a check or money order to 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois, 60154. You can also cash app us, $ Grace Central Church. And you can call us at 708-344-5020, 708-344-5020, that you may be able to support and share with us, give your tithes and offerings towards a great event. Also, I must invite you to our church, Grace Central Church, 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois, to come worship God and learn. Over here, we don't come for entertainment or anything like that, although you might enjoy a song and laugh, but we come here. Worship to me, Worship Sunday services is to worship God and learn. Worship Him because His promises are true. We're obedient to His word. We don't put ourselves in the way to put us in harm's way, but we take ourselves out of the way so that God's word can be the way. And because He proves Himself over and over, we come to church to worship Him and say, God, I thank You. I'm sincerely wanting Your direction in my life. Worship God and then learn more how to keep being our best us. Okay. All right. Every Tuesday we give apple cider grape juice. It looked like wine, but it ain't. It's grape juice. And we celebrate just like everybody else celebrate their way. We celebrate with apple cider grape juice on the messages on Tuesday. And this Tuesday, we're celebrating. It doesn't matter what's going on. Evil and how I make bad decisions and choices is already set up to whoop my behind. And it's because of me and how I'm in the way of allowing that to happen for me. But when we get out the way and allow God's word to be the way, we may be held down. But I want you to know tonight, you will not, through God's word, be held back. Cheers. ¶¶